All right, a conversation about finances may not seem romantic. I know, but avoiding it could cost you a lot more than money in the end. Financial professional Kathy DeWitt Dunn is here to give us her 5 secrets to a financially happy relationship. Good morning, Kathy.
Good morning.
Okay, so this is a hard one because you want obviously your partner is more to you than what they make or their credit score or their spending habits. But it is so, so important to, I guess, be open about that stuff, right? How do we start the conversation?
Well, it's a lot harder than it really seems. I mean,
yes.
What you have to do is you have to make a commitment to sit down with one another and talk about your finances, because we get busy with work, running the kids, social events, et cetera. So I always say that each couple in a relationship needs to sit down twice a year to review their finances.
Okay, just kind of look at where the money's going, that sort of thing.
Absolutely.
Okay, so you brought in your 5 tips, and hopefully everyone is going to listen up closely to this one. First tip here, find compromise. What do you mean by that?
Well, you know what? A relationship is all about compromise, and a lot of people don't really know where they are in the spectrum of finances, and you really just need to have a compromise on what you're going to do with your money. And I've got a great compatibility study, a financial test on my website at womenmoneyempowered.com that'll start the conversation, because you really want to take a look. Are you a saver or are you a spender? And it's really going to help you focus in on the areas that you guys can work on together.
Is this something that you do pre-marriage?
Pre-marriage, and even it's not too late,
okay,
right now, that's
this.
For sure.
You can still kind of get on board with that. So the next secret here, pool your money. And I know that this is kind of a controversial one, because a lot of people these days keep it all separate. Explain why you say pool your money is the best way to go.
Well, you know, recent studies indicate that people that pool their money together have happier marriages. It's amazing to me in relationships, because you no longer have to sit there and figure out who's going to pay what expense or who's bringing what to the table. So you're on the same page, and it creates such trust in a relationship, and then you know exactly where your money is going between both of y'all.
Hey, speaking of stay honest, and you know, women joke about this all the time. Oh, you know, I hide the receipts, hide the bags, say, oh, this old thing when you buy something. But in actuality, it is so important to be honest about where you're spending your money, right?
Absolutely. And amazing that 1 out of 3 people in a relationship have lied about money, whether it's a big
ticket
item or a small item, or hiding money, stashing things away. So you really want to be honest, and you want to create a budget. You also want to stay focused in on what your goals and objectives are later down the road. And that starts with being honest with one another.
And then 4, this is going to take some teamwork too for a lot of folks. Secret 4, eliminate debt.
Well, that's a big one, because, I mean, debt can just ruin a relationship, and also it can just ruin your retirement goals later down the road. So you always want to focus in on paying your smallest balance credit card off first, and then work up to the larger credit cards, and make sure you really focus in on getting that debt paid, because you're going to be empowered later down the road, and you're really going to be able to have a great retirement future.
Yeah, and just have a sense of camaraderie, too, with your partner in accomplishing that, too.
Yeah, and just as a team effort.
Yeah, definitely. I can see how that would work. The final one here is create rituals. What kind of rituals are these?
You know what? You have to have a ritual on how you're going to pay, you know, your bills. Take a look at organizing your investment portfolio. Mm-hmm. And just always continue to do that. Maybe it's on a monthly basis. You sit down and you review that. But the big thing is, you've worked so hard. You have all this money. You've got to have some fun. So, you don't have to spend money necessarily to have some fun. But, you know, you can go for a walk and, you know, get back to nurturing and loving one another, because all the other stuff is a lot of hard work and it takes focus. But the big thing is that, you know, if you can just find some time to spend together, you'll be so much happier in the end.
Well, that's some nice advice this time of year. Kathy, thank you. So the quiz sounds really good. If you want to take the couples quiz, it's on Kathy's website, which is linked up at our website, which is foxfournews.com. Kathy, thank you.
Thank you.
You bet.